Hello students, let us understand analytic writing, that is the short writing in the CBSE question paper which has been recently introduced. With the help of visual impetus, that is a table, we will be learning how to write an analytic paragraph. Let us begin with analytic writing. The task that we have in hand is that you should spend about 20 minutes on this task. The table shows the proportions of pupils attending four secondary school types between 2000 and 2009. Now summarize the information by selecting and reporting the main features and make comparisons where relevant. You should be able to write it within 150 words or less. Now let us begin. Let us first analyze the table. The table is showing the school attendance from the year 2000, then in between 2005 and then 2009. The duration is about 9 years, and the type of schools that are here are all secondary schools, the specialist schools, grammar schools, voluntary controlled schools, and community schools. Now, the difference that we see is that specialist school in the year 2000 were 12% students reported, or the attendance, grammar schools 24%, voluntary controlled schools 52%, and community schools only 12% students reported. But over the year, we see a drastic change. Let us just look at the last column first so that we will have a fair idea of the comparison that we are selecting to draw. Specialist schools, it has gone down by just, I think, 2%, if I'm not mistaken. Yes, 2% over 9 years. Grammar school has gone down by 50%. And voluntary control school has also gone down by more or less about half of it. Community schools, which was 12%, it has gone up over 9 years. So if you have taken this information down, it will come quite handy in writing our analytic paragraph. Now, information by information, we will be writing. Now, I have selected to draw comparison between the specialist schools and the community schools because the major difference that we see, the grammar school and voluntary school, we see a major difference that these schools, it has gone down, and community school has schools have gone up. So we'll draw a comparison between the community schools and these two together as a block, and later on we'll just establish a comparison between the specialist schools where it has gone down the minimum. If you have the information in hand, if you've written it down, it will come quite handy in writing. I request you to take the information down because when we are writing, the table might not be in front of us. Let us proceed. Now the model expression, why do I say expression? Because we are writing one or two sentences. Later on, we'll collate it into a paragraph. This is not a paragraph as such. These are just expressions that we are putting it down. The table illustrates the percentage of school children attending four different types of secondary schools from the year 2000 to 2009. It is evident that whereas the community schools experienced a marked increase in the proportion of those attending their institutions over the period, the others saw a corresponding decline. If you can see the comparative statement, a marked increase or decrease or decline, this kind of language is expected of you when you are analyzing and writing a table. Model expression over here is that to begin, the percentage of pupils in voluntary controlled schools fell from just over half to only 20% or one-fifth from 2000 to 2009. Similarly, the relative number of children in grammar schools, just under one quarter, dropped by half in the same period. As for the specialist schools, the relatively small percentage of pupils attending this type of schools, that is 12%, try writing this with comma, that will be helpful instead of the brackets, also fell, although not significantly. Now, I had already selected that voluntary controlled schools and the decline, and then the comparison to be established with grammar schools, and then later on the minor, that is the specialist school. Let us proceed. At the end, we say, however, while the other three types of schools declined in importance, the opposite was true in the case of community schools. Now I'm bringing in that comparison last, where the count went up. In fact, whereas only a small minority of 12% were educated in these schools in the year 2000, this figure increased to well over half of all pupils during the following 9 years. I have mentioned that the duration was about from 2000 to 2009. This was about 9 years. And the word limit, of course, we can cut down the word limit and we are collating it. Collating all the information as one paragraph, giving a suitable heading. Now we have collated this information as a paragraph. This is how it should look like as per the CBSE requirement. You should have the heading in place. There are marks for it, and the information that we had written separately, it has to come together as one unit or one paragraph. Otherwise, we'll lose marks on format. Paragraph means one complete unit or unity in idea. The declarative sentence over here, or the opening sentence, the declarative sentence that tells us about what is the table all about, and the summative sentence at the end gives us a complete visual idea about the increase in the attendance. And the information as per along with the table, it has just added by one word. That is all. The students are required to practice writing a comparative paragraph using the table. Kindly try writing your own independent paragraph. Then try drawing a comparison, whether you have used the comparative language, whether you have illustrated the information correctly, whether you have added values, that the percentage or marked increase or decrease with values you have written, that will make your paragraph concise. Thank you very much. Kindly practice this and writing, and if you want to add additional information, you may add the values which were in the last column. Say the, for example, the information that the percentage went up by 12% or it increased to about 50% or more. This will definitely make your information or paragraph more effective. Right now, the information that I have added is this 20% and 12%. But we had more information, more values in the paragraph. So if you want to bring in more values, you can edit this paragraph further and make it more concise and more informative, so that this becomes a completely analytic paragraph or a model paragraph, where the information is defined or explained using the tabular information. Thank you very much for your kind attention, but it is requested that you write your own paragraph. This is just the model paragraph. Thank you very much.